Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess,
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Renew your church, we pray, O Lord. The spirit with which you endowed your bishop, St. Augustine, that filled with the same spirit, we may thirst for you, the sole font of true wisdom, and seek you, the author of heavenly love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. He sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we may have life through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he was given us of the Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testified that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
How shall a young man be faultless in his way? By keeping to your words.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
With all my heart I seek you. Let me not stray from your commands.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Within my heart I treasure your promise, that I may not sin against you.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Blessed are you, O Lord. Teach me your statutes.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
With my lips I declare all the ordinances of your mouth.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
In the way of your decrees I rejoice, as much as in all riches.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
You have but one master, the Christ. Do not be called rabbi. You have but one teacher, and you are all brothers. Call no one on earth your father. You have but one father in heaven. Do not be called master. You have but one master, the Christ. The greatest among you must be your servant. Whoever exalts himself will be humbled, but whoever humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today is this beautiful obligatory memorial of St. Augustine, bishop and doctor of the church. Yesterday we celebrated his mother's memorial, beautiful gift of her persistence in prayer for her son Augustine and her dear husband, for their conversion, the welfare of their soul. All of us take care of each other in a physical way, but we also have to remember to take care of each other in a spiritual way, which is really of the height of existence, that God's Spirit breathes within each of us, and that Spirit always needs to be defended and protected. Now, saying that, it's always relying on God's grace for it, at God's time and at God's prompting, at God's movement. God does all of this. We cooperate with the grace, but it's not us. We allow ourselves to be in union with God. And in union with God, we must decrease, as John the Baptist says, and he must increase. This is very important to understand, because we could fall into a heresy that Augustine fought against, that whole heresy of Pelagius, knowing that or thinking that it's all about everything we do, and it's all about our works, and it's all about what we're going to accomplish. No, it's about all those things that have already been accomplished in Christ Jesus. And then we enter into the moment, into the mystery, and to respond to that grace. See, it gives a whole different light to it. But I say it's very important because Augustine fought for this understanding. He's the doctor of the church, which means that he has brains to sell, and that he wants us to understand the teachings of Christ, the teachings of God, to understand in right order theology, the study of God, and its orthodoxy. So we rely on God's grace. We can fall into a trap by thinking that it's all about what I'm going to do, how I'm going to accomplish this, how many things I'm going to do to make this right. But as more as the ego is inflated, the less God is dwelling within the person. And we don't want that to happen. We want to decrease so that God can increase. How can God find room in us if it's all about you and me? St. Augustine would always say, our hearts are restless, O Lord, until they rest in you. So we could be running in this rat race. We could be worrying excessively. We could have over-anxiety, anxiousness. Our hearts are restless until they rest in you. How often do we need to surrender to God, to let go and let God, especially everything that we're dealing with emotionally and physically and spiritually and psychologically with this world, the anxieties and the troubles of the world, with the health pandemic. the struggle of peace and harmony in Afghanistan, of all of the troubles that we hear. All of these things can fill us with so much anxiety and worry that if we're encircled within our own self, we have to allow God's will to be done and to allow His work to be accomplished. Now, that doesn't mean that we sit on our laurels and do nothing, but it means that in our own particular way, we cooperate with God's grace, where He allows us to do and to act in His name and to always have trust in His divine providence and His divine will. Maybe that's the most difficult thing, to have complete trust, to allow God's work to be accomplished in us and through us, and to know that His will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We say that, but we also have to mean it. You can see how this heresy, by thinking that it's ours that belongs to God, can really destroy and hurt. We even get this heresy from Pelagius through that plagiarism. Even when someone plagiarizes, it's not their work, but they take it from somebody else. It's plagiarism, all at its best. So you can see how it happens in the world when someone in college or elsewhere is writing a paper, but they're really stealing it from somebody else. They're plagiarizing. Well, that could happen also in the spiritual life. You know, it's God's work. And then we have to always footnote it, like they do on a term paper. We have to say, no, this poem is from God. I'm going to be cooperating with His grace. Now we're getting it. Now the teachings of St. Augustine are coming true and helping us to really form that grace is a gift. Right? It's that little small word, but it's really packed with transcendent theology. That grace is a gift. You can't earn it. You can't win God's love. Did you hear the first reading? How beautiful this was? From the letter of St. John. Let us love one another because love is God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God is revealed to us. It's very deep and theological. So all about what He has done and accomplished and how we enter into the moment, like right now. This has already been done. There's only one Mass. How many times did Jesus die? One time. So we're only going back to the one moment. Jesus is the Savior. It's all been accomplished. He's done everything. And now we cooperate with His Spirit. Oh yes, absolutely, without a doubt, to cooperate with His Spirit. But in cooperating with His Spirit, we always are receiving our source, our nourishment from Him who has accomplished all things. St. Augustine teaches this. He was, of course, converted. That famous line in his confession, I don't know if you ever read the Confessions of St. Augustine. If you haven't read the Confessions of St. Augustine, do yourself a favor and get it, probably on Amazon, and read the Confessions of St. Augustine. That whole line is holy liturgy, take and read, you know, knowing the love of God, knowing the scriptures, and coming to a realization that God is calling us, and He's calling us up again, and we have to respond to the grace. We have to respond to that grace and go to Him. At the age of 33, he was converted and baptized by St. Ambrose, right? St. Ambrose baptized him. And then later was ordained a priest and a bishop. And how wonderful he has brought
Augustinian order. There is priests and friars who teach us the Lola, are part of the family of St. Augustine. It's always good to understand what God is teaching us through these beautiful saints, especially the doctors of the church, when they're opening a big window for us to look in and to drink of the fountain of knowledge and of wisdom, which is God. It's ever ancient, ever new, St. Augustine said. Is that with God? Isn't he ever ancient? And yet at the same time, ever new. May we never get tired of knowing him and loving him and serving him in this world, so that we may be happy with him in the next.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governments and world leaders, may the gospel message of hope and justice inform and direct their decisions and actions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and justice in our homes and communities, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may the grace of this sacrament transform us as witnesses of Christ's love and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died marked with the sign of faith, may they rest in the eternal peace of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Taryn Quinn, Ken Rowdy, Colin Ricard, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Jack Hines, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that we may all further witness to Jesus by his grace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for I am willing to live in the walls of this holy church.
Celebrating the memorial of our salvation, we humbly beseech your mercy, O Lord, that this sacrament of your loving kindness may be for us the sign of unity and the bond of charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It
is the love of the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits, you crown your own gifts. By your way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you give us companionship, by your intercession, sure support. So that, encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us, and win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so, the angels and archangels, with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." The mystery of faith. We proclaim
your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember the word of church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who die in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Holy who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I offer you that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thus says the Lord, you have but one teacher, the Christ, and you are all brothers.
Thank you. protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O